the problem why they don't implement the court decision is actually they don't agree. There is lack of convergence on what is just between, in some of the cases, between the courts and sometimes the population and even the political side. For instance,
if you come just officially and you say, the court has decided that 5,000 people leave the parish, you say rubbish, they can't go. RDC comes in and says,
President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni was responding to calls for security agencies to respect court orders and judicial declarations. According to some judicial officers, the continued abuse of court orders continues affecting the autonomy and independence of the judiciary.
The judiciary to determine matters with impartiality, basing on the facts before them and the law. And there must be no restrictions, improper influences, inducements, pressures, threats or interference, direct or indirect, from any quarter or for any reason. Then the judiciary is under duty to exercise jurisdiction over all issues of a judicial nature and shall have exclusive authority to decide whether an issue submitted for its decision is within its competence as defined by law.
President Museveni hailed the deceased former Chief Justice for his hard work and sacrifices towards the independence of Uganda. According to Museveni, Chiwanuka always had a nationalism agenda, and despite being a Muganda, he resisted the Mengo chauvinism.
I salute CJ Chiwanuka, especially for the opposing Mengo's opportunism of chauvinism. Now, this one, he was a martyr, but he was a martyr in a situation we thought he should not have been in the first place.
Former Chief Justice of Uganda, Benedicto Chiwanuka, was dragged from his chambers at the High Court in Kampala on 21st September 1972 and assassinated by soldiers of the then President of Uganda, Idi Amin. Several decades after his death, Chiwanuka is still viewed as an icon of the rule of law in the country. The Chief Justice, Alphonse Owinyi Dollo, described the late Chiwanuka as a martyr whose legacy will forever stay in the hearts of Ugandans.
Of the observance of the rule of law, and respect for human rights, for which he paid the ultimate price. We are called upon to mirror the life of the indomitable Benedicto Chiwanuka and ask ourselves what we have so far done and what else we can do for our people.
A devout Catholic, he never missed Mass. He had Holy Communion every day. He was not a Sunday morning Christian like some of us. He was far-sighted as a politician and put Uganda first. He served ideals, not just his ambition. He was a loving husband, a loving father.
The Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs asked the government to help the family of the late Ben Chiwanuka recover his remains, which are still missing several decades after his death. Meanwhile, former Principal Judge Dr. Yorokam Bamwine and the late former Deputy Chief Justice Letitia Mukasa Chikonyogo were awarded the Ben Chiwanuka Lifetime Achievement Awards for their roles played in ensuring justice and rule of law to prevail in Uganda.
His Excellency is handing over Benedicto Chiwanuka Award to PG Emeritus, accompanied by his dear wife. Congratulations, my lord, and thank you so much.
Born in 1922, Ugandan politician Benedicto Chiwanuka was one of the early leaders in the independence movement of Uganda and led the country in the transition stage between colonial British rule and independence. He was murdered by Idi Amin in the early 1970s. Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.